was het zo'n beetje.
Ik heb al een paar keer naar Kroes gekeken hoor. Een bepaalde industrie verplicht om een soort van afloop te hebben, zeg maar.
So, this week's video is going to be a very special one because this week I'm traveling together with Dylan and my mom to Texel. Texel is one of the Dutch islands, and I went there a lot when I was younger. My mom has been there since she was like 2 years old with my grandparents, and yeah, we have a lot of special memories there. Dylan and I always used to go there in the summertime with my grandparents, and yeah, we spent a lot of time there, and it was pretty amazing for us. So it was actually my birthday gift to go to Texel. If you've seen my last video, I talked about it a little bit, but I haven't been there since my granddad died, which has been 7 to 8 years ago now, so quite a long time. And it's going to be very special to get there again and share those memories with each other. And it's also very special for us that we are going there with the three of us. So yeah, it's going to be a very special video for me, and I hope you guys will enjoy it as well. On the ferry, I went outside, and you know, that was already a very special moment, just seeing the sea, the ships, the birds. You know, it's just it gives you that feeling that you're really gone for a holiday, and it is just it felt pretty amazing. It's been so long, and you know, just the wind in your hair and that sea breeze in your face, it feels very special. It happened a lot when I was younger, so when you haven't been to a place for so long, it just feels very special. And when we got off the ferry, you see that landscape changing, you know. On Texel there is a lot of sheep, and it's just a very typical landscape. But then we drove straight to the beach because that's of course a place you want to visit first. We don't have a beach where I live very close, pretty far away, so we don't get to a beach that often, so it's always very special to watch the waves and the beautiful scenery, and just as it has a lot of beautiful memories. we drove straight to the beach and then we went to Ekelmare. And Ekelmare is like a rescue and educational center. And they have a lot of animals that live around the island, so marine life animals. A lot of seals and some fish. And what they do is they take in animals that the animals have no parents left. You know, the mother died or they are injured or they are too weak and they get stranded on the beach. And then a team of Ekelmare will go to that animal and pick up the animal to help them out, you know, to get them better. And once they are back to full health, Ekelmare will release the animal so it can go back to sea and live a normal life. And for all the animals that are too weak or, you know, too injured or too old, they will stay at Ekelmare or they will find a place for them to live a very good life. As good as possible, of course. Animals need to live in the wild and you don't want animals in a very closed environment, you know, small enclosures. But Ekelmare is, you know, for rescue animals, so that's a very important job, and it's amazing to go there because they do a lot of research as well. So they give like educational lessons in a way for people that visit there. But they also do a lot of research about the animals, about how they are living, how healthy they are, what needs to change, or maybe what is changing, and we need to help them out in a way. So that's pretty cool as well, and we went there a lot when I was younger. My grandparents also loved to visit Ekelmare. It was very special for them as well. Changed a bit over the years. It's a bit more modern now and a bit more, you know, to the educational side than it was before. So it's mostly just a rescue center. So all the small seals you see there, they will get released into the wild in a few weeks once they are strong and up to full health. But it makes it amazing to just watch those animals roam around. And you know, when they get back to nature, you know, they will not stay in this small enclosure forever. So yeah, that's pretty cool to learn about their environment around the island. Just a bit of background, you know, that's I always like to have a bit more information about what I'm seeing, especially with animals. So we really loved it there. It was a very, very special first day. And then we just checked out the island a bit more. So yeah, I just wanted to take you guys along to see the scenery, to see what it looks like, and just, you know, share a bit of the memories with you as I go. Especially because it's so special for yeah, for us as a family as well. So yeah, I really enjoyed the first day. So I am back at the place we are staying. It's actually a very nice place. It's dark now, so can't really show you too much. But my mom and Dylan are out and I stayed here, and that gives me the possibility to prepare for later when they return, because it's actually my mom's birthday tomorrow and I wanted to surprise her by, you know, decorating the room. And my mom is always, you know, up very early and we are sleeping together with the three of us in this room. So there's not really a possibility for us to do something for her birthday before she wakes up, because she will notice it when we do it. So we are doing it now. I'm just blowing some balloons here and putting them on the bed just to give her a small surprise when they return later. And tomorrow we actually have some very nice things that we're going to do. I think there's like a flea market in the morning, just a couple of streets from here, so that's very nice. We used to go there a lot with my grandparents when we were younger. My grandmother really loves all those nice small markets. She loves to spend some time looking around at all the stuff. You never know what you find. And yeah, we think it would be very nice to just spend the morning enjoying a breakfast, walking around here, looking at the flea market, and then later in the day we actually have like a boat excursion. So we are going to one of the harbors here and then we are going to hop on a boat and we are going to sail to a place where there is a lot of seals and other wildlife, you know, all kind of birds. So that's going to be very cool. And then after that, the boat continues to a harbor on the Dutch mainland at Den Helder, where there's a part of our marine harbor. So I think it would be pretty cool because you are going to go around all those marine ships, and yeah, it's very impressive. And you never see it from this side, you know. When you look at the harbor, normally you're not really allowed to go in there anyways. The marine harbor is, you know, a place you can really walk around. But if you go on this boat, they have arranged it like that. You can just go around. If you stay on the boat, it will not dock anywhere. It will just go around all the marine ships, so you can have a pretty close look at them. And yeah, I've never seen that before, so that's pretty cool as well. So yeah, very exciting day tomorrow. And then we are going to stay another night and another day. And then something very exciting as well. One of my personal favorite things to do. But you will see that later. I don't want to give everything away. But yeah, I'm going to blow some more balloons before they return. And hopefully she'll like the surprise. So for us, spending time with the three of us here, it's already very special. It's a very cool birthday gift from me as well, so I'm extremely happy we are here. And it's also a long time ago since we've done something with the three of us. You know, with all the animals around at home. Most of the times, you know, we split up when we go on a holiday. So Dylan and I stay at home when my mom leaves, and when I go, most of the times I travel together with Dylan, and then my mom's at home to take care of all the animals. But now Egbert, my stepdad, he stayed home, so he's taking care of the animals. Very glad he's there to make sure they're all doing fine, because that makes it much more enjoyable than when you are worried about the animals. And I know they are in good hands. So yeah, it's very special to be here with the three of us, and especially because we are visiting all those places, you know, we've been to years ago. It's a beautiful island, but for us it also has, you know, a lot of sentimental value. We have some very beautiful memories here as well. So that makes it even more special. And we get to share all those memories together now. And, you know, talk about all the things we remember. And yeah, that's pretty special, so it's the first day, but I'm having an amazing time already.
Oh, het is feest, tralala. Het is feest, tralala. Arme Dylan.
Leuk, hè?
Heel leuk, met mijn dropjes.
Daarom moest hij in de auto zijn.
Wat zei jij?
Daarom moest hij in de auto zijn.
Au.
Daarom was
hij het is feest, tralala, met mijn slinger.
So going on that boat excursion, that was actually something that none of us have ever done before, because it's fairly new. You know, we have been on a lot of boats also around Texel, on one of the bigger fishing boats, and also with my granddad when we were a bit younger, we went to see the sandbanks and the seals with the speedboat. It was also a very nice experience, but we have never been with this boat because it's fairly new, and this boat goes to the sandbanks. You get a lot of, you know, educational value because the captain is speaking the whole time, telling you everything about all the animal and nature around you. But then first you go to the sandbanks and see if you can see some seals laying around there in the sun, which is always very nice to see. It's a very cool experience. And then after you watch those animals, you sail to the mainland. And in the mainland, you go to the place Den Helder. And in Den Helder, you have a pretty big navy harbor. And that navy harbor is actually off limits if you go from the mainland. So there's not really a possibility to see it from up close. But this captain, I don't really know how he did it, but he has some connections with the navy, and he is allowed to go in the harbor. So he's not allowed to dock there. You cannot go on the land to see the ships, of course. You cannot really get close, but he can go around in the harbor, so you can see, yeah, from the seaside, you can see the navy harbor. And that in itself is very special, of course, but even more because we had in mind that my granddad would have loved it so much. Unfortunately, years ago when my granddad was still alive, you were not allowed to go in the Navy Harbor. This boat excursion didn't exist then. My granddad would really have loved this, and we know it because, you know, my granddad, when he was younger, he was in the Navy himself, and he just loved everything about it. So it was in a way extra special for us that we got to see it from up close, and we had him in mind the whole time, so it made it very special. And then when we left the Navy Harbor, you know, the weather changed dramatically. So it was sunny the whole way there, and then we left the harbor and the clouds were getting, you know, darker and darker, and the rain started. And the seas got pretty rough as well. So it was a whole different experience. It got pretty bad at some point. You know, luckily I don't get seasick that easily. And there were still some fishermen out and about. So it was pretty cool to just stand outside and look at them and experience what it feels like when you are out at sea with, you know, rough weather. So a lot of rain on the way back, but it was an amazing experience, especially with my granddad in mind. You know, it made it even more special. And then when we got on the island again, the sun started to come out, and the weather was very nice again. So, an amazing experience. Standing here in the wind, you can see Dylan and my mom over there. There's a lot of people over there. We're all waiting for something really special we're going to do. So it's a bit windy, but it's dry now. Yesterday we had some rain. When we came back with the boat, it was raining a lot. It was a bit stormy, also a bit of a rough sea, but pretty cool as well. And I'm used to it a little bit, so it's fine for me. I don't really get seasick or anything. But today we are going to make a bit of a tour through nature mostly, like a nature reserve in the dunes next to the sea. Very beautiful, but with horses. So in a big car behind some very big horses, and we did this when we were younger a few years ago. I think the last time we were here I talked about it with my mom, and she thinks it's 8 years ago we also did it. So yeah, we have some pretty fond memories, and of course we all love horses very much, and seeing the nature from up close is always a very cool experience as well. So we're just waiting here for them to arrive, and then we're going to enjoy a few hours in nature. And it's our last day already, so after that we are going to go back into this small town here, grab some food, and then start the journey home, which will, of course, we need to take the ferry again, and then it's a few hours drive home. But yeah, I'm looking forward to this very much. It's one of the most exciting things to do here, I think. So yeah, I'm very excited to take you guys along as well. And maybe there won't be that much talking, because the wind is blowing so hard. I don't even know if you can hear me very well right now. But yeah, just wanted to explain a little bit of what we're going to do. I hope it stays dry, but I think in the car you said like it's dry there. It has like a top on top of it. And the wind is not really a problem. It happens a lot on the island, so yeah. It's very nice. I'm pretty excited. So just waiting for the horses to arrive now, and then start our journey.
So going with the Jan Plezier, the horse carriage, that was something that we have done many years ago with my grandparents when we were a lot younger, and it's always a special experience. But I wanted to talk to you guys a bit about the horses. Some of you might think it's a very hard job for horses, because it's, you know, a large carriage with a lot of people. But those are two Belgian draft horses. They are very strong, and the horseman, he has 12 of those horses, so they don't really need to work a lot. They work one day in the week, and then they have, you know, rest days a lot. They are very well taken care of. He makes sure the terrain they go on is very easy for them to go on. They are never too tired. They love working. So don't worry, guys, the horses are extremely well taken care of. And it's also, you know, it's very amazing as well, because it goes into the Slufter, and that's a nature reserve. You are not really allowed to walk in, so you go with the horses, and then you can see the beautiful nature there, and it's just an amazing experience in itself. So I really love that. We really enjoyed it.
We are waiting to go with the ferry, and you can see one of the ferries behind me. It's in the water right now. It looks like it's in the dunes, but they go in summertime when it's very busy every 30 minutes from the mainland to the island and back. Every 30 minutes you can take a ferry, but now, because you know, the summer season is over, they go every hour. And we're a bit early, but I don't really mind, so I can film some things for you. You can see one of the ferries. This is the extra one. And you know, the slightly bigger one is going right now to the mainland. Then it comes back here, and then we'll take it. But sorry for the noise. I don't know what that's. Sorry for the wind as well. But yeah, pretty big ship. A lot of cars go on there. Yeah, I'm going to walk around. It's a bit rainy. I can see my mom joining me over there. She is the yellow pink lady over there. And my brother is still in the car. He didn't want to go out in the rain. But yeah, just going to walk around, see if we can enjoy some nice views here. Hey mom.
Koud?
Yeah.
So we found a dry spot to wait. Mom is over here. You can see one of the ferries over there. It's called the Dr. Wagenmaker. And they replace the ferries every 20 years or something. My mom used to go here when she was very little. And you remember the old ferries, the very small ones. And yeah, this one is a lot bigger. The first time you went to Texel. Do you remember the name? Oh, show yourself. Kom maar even naast me staan.
The first time I didn't realize I was here. I was 2 years old.
When
I realized going on holiday to the islands, I think the first boat called Texelstroom.
Texelstroom.
And Marsdiep.
And that's 50 years ago.
Almost.
Yeah. And now we have two of those very big ones. When I was a bit younger, this one you see over here was the new one. It was very, big and very luxurious on board. You know, you can eat there. It has a restaurant, but it goes to the mainland in like 20 minutes or so. It used to take a lot longer. I think the first time you went, it was maybe
half an hour.
Half an hour. Oh, that's all right. 40 minutes?
I think half an hour. When we came to the island and it was in the season, and every half an hour.
Yeah. So already
half an hour.
Pretty quick. And now it's like you step on board and in 20 minutes you're to the other side. So it goes very quickly. Not really a lot of time to eat something. You can get out of the car and watch, you know, over the seas and the other boats. And when it's the summer season and they use two boats, like we had when we got here, then you can watch the other boat come by and it's very cool to see. But now you can see some things when you're on there. It's a bit stormy now, so it's not so nice to go outside. Mom is moving away from the camera. She's still here. You don't want to show yourself.
Yeah, I'm here.
She's here. But then you can see the other one and right next to you. But now it's pretty.
I can't see on that. Over 10 minutes, I see you on the other.
It's pretty stormy right now. We were lucky with the weather though. We had a few beautiful sunny moments. Yesterday, the beautiful sunset. We really enjoyed the both of us. And Dylan, of course.
Great. You are wet.
Yeah. Yeah, I accidentally...
Now you have new shoes.
Yeah, I have new shoes because yesterday, I think Dylan took a picture of it. I was a bit surprised by the sea coming so close, and Dylan didn't warn me as well, so I was hit by some very cold salty water. I know, it's not his fault. He could have warned me, but he didn't.
You see the rain.
Oh yeah, the rain is crazy right now. You can't really see the mainland anymore. It's raining. We are dry here, but it's raining pretty bad, and the wind started to pick up yesterday as well when we were on the boat to watch the Navy Harbor. Was pretty cool as well. My mom had never did that before. You are not allowed to watch the Navy Harbor from the other side, you know, from the mainland. But this boat, I don't know how they do it, but I think he has connections with some people there. Yeah, he knew everything about it. You know, the captain of that boat. So he probably has some friends in the Navy because he is allowed to go there. So that was pretty cool to see as well, because we have never been up close to the ships before. And now we did. And when we were there, the storm started and, you know, the boat trip back was a bit different. Not so sunny and a bit stormy. But neither one of us gets seasick very easily. So it's fine for us. And on this, on this ferry, you don't really notice it when it's storming a lot. It's so big, you know, it can have some bad weather before you notice it. But I will probably get out of the car anyway to show you guys around a little bit, because it's only a short time. But and then we'll enjoy the rest of the journey home. See the animals when we are back home. Who did you miss the most?
My husband.
Oh, Egbert, of course. And besides Egbert, one of the animals maybe?
All the animals.
Oh.
My little chickens.
Oh, her little pigs. Chickens. Pigs, of course.
My dogs.
Bobble. And Koekje.
And Koekje.
Yeah.
And Zeno.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to seeing Zeno the most. You know, with the horses, I miss them, but I think they are fine without me. You know, when Egbert feeds them and makes sure they have a lot to drink and to eat, they don't really notice I'm gone that much, you know. It's just, oh, there's some rain on you guys. They are fine with me leaving for a few days, so yeah, but I'm also very happy to go back. It was an amazing birthday gift, but yeah, I also look forward to being on the ferry again. I think it's pretty cool. So yeah, I think we are going to go to the car now and then go inside, wait till it arrives, and then I will show you around a bit more. I also showed you when we got here. I didn't really get the chance to talk to you guys very much because of the wind. I found a place out the wind now, but that's why it's been a bit quiet, because it's so windy here that it's hard to talk to the camera. But yeah, I will see what I can do on the ferry. Probably be very windy, but maybe when we're inside I can show you a little bit more and talk to you guys a little bit more. But yeah, outside on the ferry now. I'm under a roof kind of structure, so I'm not getting wet, but I don't know if you can see behind me, the weather's not great. Dylan and my mom are staying inside because they think it's a bit too bad weather, and they've seen this already quite a lot of times, but yeah, I wanted to take you guys outside to show what it looks like. It's very large here. I was over that spot showing you how we left the harbor there, and now I don't know if you guys can see it, but the mainland is over there. Somebody, oh, there's also somebody over there. I'm not completely alone here. But yeah, mainland also over there. So we'll be there in 5 to 10 minutes now. It goes pretty quickly. The wind is blowing a lot, but yeah, I really enjoyed this trip. It was very special for all of us. For the three of us, we don't go out with the three of us that often anymore. And I like to spend some time with my mom. Also with my dad, of course. We take some trips together with the three of us, with my dad as well. We went to Rome, and I think we are going to do one of those trips again pretty soon, hopefully. But now it was with my mom, and it was amazing. I loved the time together, but also loved being on the island again. It's been a long time for me. 8 years, we figured. So very special memories here as well. And yeah, it's pretty amazing to share those memories with each other, especially for my mom as well, because she has been, well, I don't know how many years, but since she was like 2 years old, she's been here with her parents. And Dylan and I went every summer with my grandparents, so you know, it feels a bit special. And now look how beautiful this is. only like this, you know, moments like this I enjoy. It's not that special maybe, but just standing here, feeling the sea breeze in my face, the saltiness in the air. Yeah, it's pretty amazing. But I see we're almost there, so I need to go to the car, find Dylan and my mom first, and then need to go to the car. But yeah, we'll see each other on the road back home. And then I will show you guys a bit of the road as well. Some parts of the Netherlands. You guys ask for it sometimes if I can show a bit more of the Netherlands. And I will try to, because we are traveling through it quite a lot today. So I will show a bit more when we are in the car, from the surroundings of the country and a bit of the special views maybe. The weather is not great now, so I don't know what I can show, but I'll try to show you things I like. If it's raining all the time, probably not as beautiful as it is when the sun is out, but I still like it. I mean, look at this behind me. It's pretty. I enjoy it a lot. But yeah, let's find them now. Dylan, because he knows the road better than I do, but it should be another hour or so if there's no traffic. If there's bad traffic, then it can take a few hours, but it's still windy here, but yeah, I think it should be an hour or so. There she is. So we're going to continue. As you guys can see, I'm back home again. It's nice to be back again. I always miss the animals when I'm gone, but I also like to see a bit of the world, you know. I really love living here, but I also think the whole world is a beautiful place to explore. And yeah, in the years I have on this earth, I would like to see as much of it as possible. But yeah, it's good to be back home again, and I really enjoyed that trip with my family, and it was very special for me. But it's also very nice to be back here and watch the animals, you know. I love it here as well, so it's always good to be back. And yeah, I really hope you guys enjoyed this video, and it's something different than what I normally show, but yeah, I really love to travel, so if I'm going to a beautiful place, of course I like to share it with you guys as well. So yeah, that's what I did now, and this was a very special one for me as well, because it was to Texel, where we have a lot of beautiful memories. And yeah, very special, and I'm happy I get to share it with you guys. If you liked it and you haven't subscribed to my channel already, please do so, because it really helps the channel grow. And yeah, I love to do what I'm doing now, and I love to share everything with you guys. So it means a lot to me if you guys leave a comment, give a like, subscribe, or just watch, because that already means a lot to me, of course. And you will probably see some travel videos in the future as well. Of course, I showed it when I traveled together with Dylan to France, and now with my mom and Dylan to Texel. And In the end of October, the beginning of November, I will travel to Egypt with my dad and his wife and children. So that's going to be another nice trip with family. So I'm looking forward to that as well, and I will share it with you guys as well. And yeah, you can feel already the seasons are changing very much. When we got home, it was raining, you know, the whole way back. First it started out beautiful and then the rain started. And now it's very nice, but it is cold. You know, it's chilly at night. And last night I think it was only like 5 degrees Celsius. And that's pretty cold, because 2 weeks ago it was like 38 degrees Celsius. So yeah, it's cooling down a lot now. Autumn is really here. So I think we will have some nice sunny days the coming week. And then after that, it will drop, you know. It will get very cold quickly. And I think also the rain will start, which is, of course, not that nice. You know, I love a cozy autumn feeling. And I'm probably going to start some more DIY projects inside, you know, making candles and all that nice work. I love those small projects as well, but I also love to spend time outside, and I don't mind the cold. I'm fine with cold, and it doesn't really get cold here, you know. It's not like it will get minus 20 or something. That doesn't really happen here, but yeah, it's definitely starting to get colder, and I can feel it. But I'm looking forward to a beautiful autumn season as well. So yeah, well guys, thank you for watching, and I will see you next week.